concerned that we need Sharia law for comment.
Yeah. No, you see, this is a very complicated issue, but nevertheless, in simple terms, you know, Sharia comes in quite late when, you know, Prophet, peace be upon him, when we look into the whole phase of Islam, how Islam came into, you know, establishment and in Medina particularly, and that's where the, but we need to have the training first. And by the way, there are two things. Number one, if you want to have, let's say, you want to have the Sharia law is for those people who submit to God, who says they are Muslims. And there are exceptions for non-Muslims in that, in those laws also. So we need to find out what do you mean by Sharia law. And as far as the Sharia is concerned, this is very, you know, misunderstood terminology that this is, you know, some laws that are very barbaric or what so not. But Sharia literally means the pathway. And this word, by the way, is used in the Quran also as by saying, like, you know, this is an the ayah, شَرِعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ, which means that the Sharia, the path, which has been given to the other prophets also. So there is a code of conduct to do it, but then we need to train people. You know, similarly, law is there, but we what inspires Islam also for the people that who are believing in it, the spirit is so that we can morally enhance them, develop them, character development. So that's what it is. I personally, you know, this could be an opinion, but we need to do the training part first. Then probably, you know, and this is what happened during the lifetime of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, may peace be upon him, that he trained, and this was his biggest achievement, the people that he trained. And then after that, though the laws were there, but how many times do the laws apply? We need to look into the history. So the purpose of the law is to maintain justice in the society, is not, you know, chopping. So for that, we need to educate people, we need to train, we need to make sure everything that can be applicable. I guess, you know, but this requires a lot more time, but in this limited time, this is my take on this question. I hope that if you are not satisfied, inshallah, we can spend more time on it. But if anybody else also would like to address this question.
That's an eloquent answer. Just let me add really quickly, right? It's very important for us to know, because sometimes when we look at the Arabic terminology, we may become confused by the classical definitions and all of that. Very simple, Sharia law means how to manual. How to manual. We have how to manual for employees, we have how to manual for students. Sharia law means the how to manual God gave guidance for individual and for humanity. The Sharia law given to Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not unique. We say that Sharia law was given to Prophet Jesus and to Prophet Moses and the prophets before him. Number one. Number two, very, very important. Sometimes when people think of the Sharia law, the very first thing that comes to their mind is what?
Chopping hands.
Right? It's very, very important. I'll give you one analogy, by the way. Very simple analogy. Suppose if men from Mars, if they come down now. Is it men from Mars or women from Mars? Okay. People from Mars, if they come down. And if they ask me the question, you know, Dr. Sabeel, what is the U.S. Constitution? And if I tell them that the U.S. Constitution kills people by lethal injection, by hanging, by electrocution, and that's all I say and then leave, would I be doing justice to the U.S. Constitution? I'm just mentioning to them only maybe like 0.5% of the breadth and the beauty of the U.S. Constitution. In the same way, the punishment or the penal system in the Sharia law, there are no less than only 15 or less passages in the Quran that speaks about the punishment system. Every country has punishment system. There has to be checks and balances. The rest of the Sharia law speaks about respecting the neighbors, honoring your parents, being good to our fellow Americans, being good to the minorities, gaining education, enhancing the society, and joining good, forbidding evil, giving charity, all of those things are part of the Sharia law. Me smiling at you, I'm practicing the Sharia law. So in fact, those who feared that Sharia law is going to come here, Sharia law came here a long time ago. In the US Constitution, that speaks about the justice and the equality, that we say that's part of the Sharia law. Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said that an Arab is no superior to a non-Arab. A non-Arab is no superior to an Arab. A white person is no superior to a non-black, and black is no superior to a white.
Salaam alaikum. That will be called inside about 30 seconds. All
of your children of Adam, and Adam was made from dust. That is part of the Sharia law. Speaks about equality. So it's very important for us to know what Sharia law is and not. Maybe just in 20 seconds. Sharia law is not. Sharia law is against oppressing minorities. Sharia law is against forced conversions. Sharia law is against suppression of women. It is there to enhance the society. So hopefully we'll come back maybe after the Adhan.
To answer your question, no, we don't want to miss Israel.
Yeah, I'm having a white.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.